God. I am belongs to group number 3. As we know the about our the starting of our workshop, first we pray for our Holy Spirit, and then brother introduce about our workshop. It's a not a workshop, it's a evangelization he introduced. Brother is very well explain all about the points. I think in this age he will this much attitude to work in the for Holy Spirit for the evangelization programs. We will claps together for his very in this age he take the courage here. Then tell about the evangelization programs in simple way. Then some songs are we studied. We are discuss about the points only. Through the recollection we get some points. I read this only the points only. I can explain it to another in this is as for boring. I can only point only. First we know the as know about that Jesus is the light of the world, and in the that light, it means the flame, we accept this flame, and we are receiving this flame, then we become the Jesus, and we are proclaim the word, we share the Jesus to other persons. First we receive the Jesus, and we can share the Jesus for others. Brother explained very much about the charism of our life. We should know, we should recognize the charism, and we will daily we in our personal prayer we pray to our grace how to this charism we continue, how to fervently we pray for our pray for the grace for the charism. Then we can lead our religious life in successful or in meaningful. Then he explained that incarnation of Christ, what is the purpose of Jesus to incarnate in the world, to make the God coming in the world, and then for purposes the man becomes son of God. That means God come to in the world, and for the man become son of God. It's a great responsibility our Jesus taken that responsibility in, because he is a Lord, he is the first creation. In the incarnation of Christ, our all human himself he collected. Then the other point is our grace. The grace is the participation in the life of Christ. And then he introduced the catechism of the Catholic Church. We to advise that in one hand the Bible, and another hand the CCC. It's our cornerstone in our life. Then the other point is based off the radical change in the according to St. John, the first I heard that the word is said transubstantially, but the meaning it's the what is the meaning of transubstantiation. I heard that I understand today's class. Another point is the our Holy Spirit, how to use this Holy Spirit in our vision in our day-to-day life. He will example for his own examples he explained very well. then I have one striking point is the one person asked what is the Holy Spirit, what is the evil spirit. Brother shared that Holy Spirit is the creator and the evil spirit is the only the creation, creature, only the creature. It will strike me very well. Then about the our vocation and charism, then the Acts of Apostles chapter 2 verses 17, the work of Holy Spirit in the last days. In the last days the God declares Holy Spirit upon your son and daughter, they shall prophesy, and your young man shall see visions and old man shall dream dreams. It will be very inspired in our group. We also in our life how to get the Holy Spirit only through the prayer, only through the sanctification, receiving of sacraments, we can get the Holy Spirit in our life. Then another point is obedience. That obedience is the root of all grace. We can the obedience, we can get the grace in fullness. Then the obedience is the root of sins. We as know that disobedience is the root of sins. So it will make the change in our life. This is the formula in our religious life. In future we can apply this formula. Then what is the Christianity? He explained with the example of the lotus. In all circumstances we have the chance to sins, temptations that provoking. We all these circumstances we can grow with the grace and fullness of holiness. That's the challenge of our in the Christianity. Then Jesus take human body, that means he has taken the everybody in every body in human body in himself. That is about the incarnation. Then the word Jesus, what is the meaning of Jesus? We all heard about the only the Emmanuel. We know have heard of that only the word Jesus. We don't meditate the word Jesus. Then these classes we get that meaning of Jesus. In Hebrew God saves our life. That's the meaning of Jesus. When got some visions, we pray for the grace of Holy Spirit. We workshop in that workshops we get visions. Then he called that visions are the revelation. That will it will be inspired in our group. These revelations are for our improve the grace, improve the visions. We can very encouraged in our life. The other point of the what is the end of the world? The end of the world is the kingdom of God within fullness. Then the difference between Jesus in there and Jesus not in there. The what has happened? We know, as we know that what has happened, the disciples, Jesus in with them, they can do many things. But in the crucifixion, after the crucifixion of our Jesus, the disciples are spread. They look their own duties, but they get no result in their works. But the interception of our Jesus, it will. They know the what is the their purpose, what is their vocation. Then they returned their the proclamation of Jesus. Then the mission of Jesus, we can study in the we can understand in these classes. Luke chapter 4 verse 13, that anointed the Lord is beloved me and anointed the good news to the poor, proclaim the good news to the poor. That's the mission of Jesus. Then we participate the workshops. We shared the prayer to the gift of Holy Spirit. Pray to the gift of Holy Spirit. Then we about in today's classes what is the Holy Eucharist? What is happening in the Holy Eucharist? What is happening in the liturgy? The Christ manifest, Christ makes present, Christ communicates his works and proclaim the good news to all. He himself communicates in this liturgy. Then the eight parts of the Holy Eucharist. I also in the personal experience, the eighth point, that there is a seven parts of the Holy Eucharist, but the eighth point is very interesting, the coming of our Jesus, second time coming of our Jesus. That is inspired. Then one inspired story is that how to begin the monasteries. Saint Anthony's of Desert, it will be the parable of richest. He inspired the word of the God to sell your properties and give to the poor. That is the life of the religious, the beginning of the religious life, that the monastery. It will inspire that. We thank you, Lord, for the good classes, good preaching of the evangelization, preaching of the good news in these classes. Thank Lord and thank brother and all to thank you. Thank you.